Hi everyone, my name is Marcus and you're watching the Reef Nerd YouTube channel. So a few videos ago I teased a certain piece of equipment that I have and that I'm going to be running on my new tank. This video is going to be an introduction to UV sterilizers and a look at how they can be set up. So I chose the Pentair Smart UV 50 watt model. In Australia, Pentair's UVs of all sizes are available from Fresh by Design. They're a company that specializes in commercial aquaculture, large public aquariums, though they also have a number of products that are suitable for home aquarium applications. They offer same day shipping and zip pay options on their website, freshbydesign.com.au, so you should check them out. Other than UVs, they also have titanium Schwago heaters, which are really popular because they're by far the longest lasting and highest quality heater in the aquarium market at the moment. They have plumbing supplies, test kits, but one other thing that really caught my eye is a super unique and awesome fish finder drone submarine camera thing. I mean, it's straight out of a James Bond movie. Anyone who's a gear junkie or really, really into fishing would probably have a wet dream over this thing, so go check it out. But of course, one of the most popular things they offer for the home aquarium scene would be the Pentair line of UVs. The reason why I selected a Pentair UV sterilizer is because they're a high quality, real professional tool designed for applications where performance and results actually matter, like aquaculture. These are no toy. They offer exact guidelines on how to use the products to achieve the exact desired results. There's no ambiguity. There's no, oh, it kind of works and we make some kind of ambiguous claims. These things are the real deal. It's very important when it comes to UV that you get it right, because if it's done wrong, it may as well not be done at all. So what can you achieve with UV on marine fish tank? Well, primarily there's two reasons why people run UV. The first being water clarity, algae control, keeping the glass clean, preventing bacterial blooms, that kind of thing. And the second is to kill pest protozoa and parasites, such as cryptocarian irritants, or more commonly known marine white spot, or ick. It will also prevent the spread of things like of other parasites, like velvet and stuff like that. Effective use of UV can be a cure for an ick outbreak, and it can also be a prevention to prevent one ever occurring. It's important to understand these two goals and know that they are separate. Usually, they cannot both be achieved simultaneously. The reason for this is that algae and bacterial control needs a really high flow rate and a display tank turnover rate. That's because these kinds of organisms reproduce really quickly. So to keep them under control and prevent algae taking hold on the glass or bacterial blooms from occurring that might cloud your water, the entire tank needs to be run through the UV a certain number of times an hour. Whereas to disrupt the life cycles of more complex life forms, such as protozoa and parasites, a much higher dose of UV is required, and therefore the exposure time to the water needs to be higher, and therefore the flow rate needs to be lower. Some people do manage to achieve both by dramatically oversizing the UV so they can run it at both a high dose and a high tank turnover rate, but this is not economical for most people. What you can do, however, and what I recommend you do, is size a UV appropriately for your tank as recommended by Pentair for treating parasites. And then, when you no longer need to treat for parasites or they've been eradicated from your tank, increase the flow rate to switch it to target algae and bacteria, and then you'll achieve the crystal clear water and your glass will remain clean for far longer. Obviously, your choice of pump will be important here to ensure that you've got the range in flow rate to be able to do this. Now, obviously, my new system is not quite ready yet, and I'll be having a lot more updates coming on that very soon. Fear not, we are getting very, very close. But in the meantime, I didn't want to just have this huge, awesome UV sterilizer sitting here doing nothing. So I've set it up temporarily here on my existing system. Now, it is massively oversized for this system, for sure, but there's no issue running an oversized UV. In fact, it's a common way to successfully treat bad existing outbreaks of something like cryptocurrying irritants or ick. As a fast way to establish a breakdown in that parasite's life cycle and give your fish the best chance of survival and reducing their exposure as quickly as possible. Though, of course, prevention is better than reactionary treatment. So, as with all things, I'd recommend running it before you have a problem rather than waiting to have a problem. There's a video that was recently done by Cam the Fish Guy over at Gallery Aquatica TV, where he used an oversized Pentair UV to effectively treat ick in his customers' tanks. I'd highly recommend everyone to go and check out that video and Gallery Aquatica TV in general. So while my temporary setup of this oversized UV on my current tank is not here to treat ick, thankfully my tank is ick-free through tank transfer method and quarantine of new fish, what I hope to achieve from running it is to reduce my daily glass cleaning requirements down to maybe twice a week or less. So as you can see here how I have it set up, I've used adapters to go from the 2-inch imperial bulkheads to a 32mm barb and some soft tubing. This is fine as a temporary setup. It may not be that pretty, but as I said, it's temporary. I'm going to cover the exact hard plumbing installation when I do that on my big system upgrade, so stay tuned for that. I achieved this adaption down to the soft tubing with a 2-inch to 1.25-inch reducing fitting. Then I used Sanking's Imperial to Metric DIN adapter. And then once you're in the Metric DIN standard, you can use any of Sanking's flow color plumbing, which is the most common plumbing that we're using on tanks these days. Some of the important points to know about installing a UV is you must make sure that no air can get trapped in the unit. That means that either you do a vertical orientation or a horizontal orientation with the inputs and outputs facing upwards. Additionally, in a horizontal orientation, the output should be slightly higher than the input. This will ensure that any bubbles that do get in the system will always flow through and out of the UV. It's also very important that the output of the unit goes back into the display. Its efficiency and effectiveness will be dramatically reduced if you have a closed loop to your sump. Remember, a key fact in dosing UV is that all the water in the system is treated a certain number of times per hour. If you're drawing from and outputting to your sump, this will severely limit your dose to whatever your sump's turnover is, which is typically far from sufficient for a UV sterilizer application. As I said before, the primary purpose of me running UV on this system is to control algae, bacterial blooms, and keep my glass clean. In tanks like mine, with highly dense coral and a very large bio load and very strong lighting, keeping the glass clean can be an absolute nightmare. Low bio load tanks or tanks with weak lighting might only need their glass cleaned once a week or twice a week tops. But with a tank like mine that's fed a lot of amino acids, my glass can go from being crystal clean to a green film in a matter of hours. I normally need to clean my glass daily, but realistically, I could do it more often than that if I wanted it to look pristine all the time. So how effective is it in keeping my glass clean in a tank with as high a bio load as this? Well, let me show you the results. This is my glass prior to the UV at 28 hours post the last clean. As you can see, it is a total mess. You can barely see through the glass. This is what I sometimes have to deal with every day or every second day tops due to my strong lights and high bio load. After installing the UV, cleaning the glass, and then waiting, this is now 6.5 days counting without cleaning. It should be go without saying that I'm absolutely thrilled. I've never gone this long without cleaning my glass and having it look this clean since I think when my tank was cycling. Cleaning the glass is one of the most tedious chores for me in the hobby and something that has become worse with time as the bio load of my tank has increased. What you might also notice, and I'm not sure how well this is picked up on camera, but my water is crystal clear. Now, I've always had clear water due to effective filtration in my sump, but right now it kind of looks like the fish are flying. I plan to do a few more videos on UV as a topic, particularly as I install this unit permanently in my new tank, where I'll be running it hard plumbed from day one. So for that and lots of other content, I release new videos every week. So please subscribe and like the video if you enjoyed this one. Anyway, that's all for today. I hope you found this video helpful. If you've got any questions about UV, please post them down below. I read all the comments and I try to reply to as many as I can. My name is Marcus and you've been watching the Reef Nerd YouTube channel. Bye for now.